Since 1991, ProTaper has led the way in premium control components and prides themselves on providing an exciting, innovative, and complete product line to fulfill the needs of professional racers and weekend riders alike. Through revolutionary ideas like the oversized 1 1/8-inch handlebar and the micro handlebar kit, the only control system purpose-built for youth riders, ProTaper continues to push the limits and transform how we experience riding our motorcycles. Visit ProTaper.com for more. Here we go. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Kickstart Podcast, presented by our friends at ProTaper. It's Tuesday. We're a day late, not a dollar short, because ARay went home to Tennessee over the weekend.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I got back last night. It was fun. It was good to see the fam. I just hadn't seen them in a while, so I figured I'd go home, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So it was nice. It was good to get back.
I like the family portrait.
You like that?
Yeah, the family portrait was good. Ronnie looked good in his flannel.
Oh, yeah.
The dinner pictures made me hungry.
Oh, yeah. My gosh, man. Like, they don't do me any favors, you know? I started last week on training, and, it's always like that whenever I go home. My mom, she loves to cook, and we usually have dinner at, like, 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Oh.
We'll have, like, only 2 meals, and both meals are huge, right? So, it was really hard for me to keep the fork down, but we're back in California now. We're back on the program, and we're ready to move forward.
Home cooking.
Oh, yeah. Home cooking is always good.
I saw you burning the miles, burning them calories off in the dojo on Kenny Bell's story this morning.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I was in there just on Zwift, you know, just pedaling away indoors.
You know, I don't think you should wear white bibs right now.
Definitely not. I didn't know that he was just going to come in and just start videoing me, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was thinking that the whole time he was videoing. I was just like, dang, he got me at the wrong time, man.
The white bibs.
Yeah, the white bibs. Mm-hmm. And my bibs, my gear, my clothes, everything's a little tight right now. But it'll loosen up here in a couple weeks, I hope.
It wasn't all play, though. You did some work, some riding at back home, right? Just a little bit?
Yeah.
ARay got back on the bike this weekend.
Yeah, I got back on a dirt bike. A little bit.
How was it?
I putted around. It was nice.
Did you just putt around, or did you do jumps and
hit? No jumps.
No jumps.
No jumps. No.
Are you cleared yet?
No.
Oh, you're not cleared?
No.
Okay.
No, I'm not. My right wrist, everything's good with my right wrist. The one that looks like it's just got a cheese grater went through it. But my left wrist, it's still not healed up a little bit more, and we'll be ready to go. But I'm close.
Mm-hmm.
We're close. We're getting there.
That's good.
The one that's partially fused, I thought I was going to have to, like, chicken wing it super bad, but yeah. I really...
Right? Because you twist throttle like a doorknob.
Yeah. I didn't notice it that much, which was relieving to me. I was just like, man... Because I was riding a pit bike in the yard, and I'm like, man, how am I going to ride an actual dirt bike?
Yeah.
How am I going to do that? So, I got on the bike, and everything was a bit different, but after a few laps, I kind of got used to it, which was a relief for me because I was like, man, how am I going to ride a dirt bike? Is this going to be the end of,
yeah,
you know, like, I don't know. But it was good for me, I think, to ride a few laps and mm-hmm. just to get that stress out, you know. So I feel like everything's going to be fine now. So we're good.
What did you ride? Did you ride your dad's old Elsinore?
No, he has a, he's got a, like a 76 KX 252 stroke.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, okay. That's what he's got.
Nice.
Yeah.
So, anyhow, Anton, some big news broke on Swapmoto Live this weekend. You had the good old news break going, but you had some research that you did with the guys that failed. The whole vaccine mandate has been a hot topic of sorts. You want to fill us in?
Yeah. I mean, pretty much it kind of seems like we're going to do what we did last year to get to races. You know, there's a lot of controversy right now, and there's been a lot of people, you know, saying, and you know, rightly so, there, we've seen what happens in like the NFL and Major League Baseball and NBA and all that, so I think people are just like a little wary of the same things happening in our world. But the big thing that people always have to keep in mind is that they have a collective bargaining agreement, and they have a players association and all of these other things that those guys in Major League Sports somewhat agree to, or then go through and they settle those protocols. We don't have that. This is where that whole riders union, team union thing would come in. Feld, knowing that, is like, hey, yeah, we're not going to be able to make them do anything. We can't make them do anything yet. And as it stands, you know, as of today, There's no schedule. There's no venue on the schedule that makes a vaccine mandatory the same way that other venues have it right now. You know, if you wanted to go to a Raiders game at that New Vegas stadium, you have to have a vaccine. There is no ifs, ands, or buts about it. You have to have it. Mm-hmm. But if you go to like a concert there or you go to something else, you don't have to. You can have a negative test.
Really?
Everybody kind of looks at, you know, Seattle as this like hell pit, you know, just like, oh my God, whatever they're doing up there is whatever. But, you know, as they've said too, 72 hours, you can come into Lumen Field, you know, where the race is going to be, same thing. And then, you know, here in the Corn Belt of America, you have to have the same thing to go to events in St. Louis. Mm-hmm. So it's not just like, fuck the West Coast, it's all this. It's whatever local municipalities and local governments have instilled, and then that's what we're going to have to go through. For us, you know, for credentialed people, racers, media people, mechanics, teams, testing, whatever. Testing, no ifs, ands, or buts about it. You're going to have to do it. It's going to be the same thing as last year. But, I mean, ARay, you could probably attest to this from other people in the pits. After seeing how easily it was for so many guys to get sick and have their performance drop off and all the other stuff that's going to happen next year, I would think that some high-level race teams are going to be like, hey, that's okay. If we know that there's no problems like that, we'd be good with it.
Yeah.
You know, because if you've put so much time and effort into it and then you get to round 12 and you get sick because everybody was careless about it and you lost your championship, you're going to be pretty pissed. Oh, as it 100%. Stands right now, though, you know, there's nothing in there that says, like, hey, if you don't have it, you can't race or anything like that. You're just, I would assume that the test that you take to get your credentialed wristband is going to be the same thing to get, you know, into the stadium as a competitor or as a credentialed guy. For fans, you know, 90% of the people listening to this, you guys are going to be, you know, kind of left on your own. It's whatever the stadium says. Like, if you go to AT&T Stadium in Texas and they say it's one way, that's what you guys got to do. If it goes to, you know, Anaheim Stadium and it's another way, then that's what it is. It's what the local venues have in place. Mostly that's the stuff that's going to affect the front-facing crowd. You know, for us in the back, it's going to be the same pretty much everywhere we go.
Same as it's been, correct?
Same as it's been, yeah.
So what about, we've heard rumors of some teams having a vaccine requirement. Have you heard anything concrete about that, or is it just rumors?
So I haven't heard about like any, we've all heard rumors about a couple teams, you know, if you don't have it, you can't work here, or you have a deadline or this, and this, that you're going to get fired. But I haven't heard like concrete proof of that being in stone yet. Mm-hmm. I do know that there is one factory team right now that has requested all of their people get the vaccine. They would prefer that if you did, and it is a factory team, and this goes all through corporate for top to bottom for everyone in the company.
I'm guessing it's red.
What's that?
My guess is red.
My guess is blue.
Blue?
Nope. No. Yeah, so but those two apparently are pretty close behind on this from what I'm hearing. But if you don't have it by a certain date, then you would have to wear a mask and have all these other things that they're going to be a little bit more on you about. So, you know, there's stuff like that, but that's just corporate procedure right now. You know, there's a lot of places that are making that happen, and that's what these companies are doing. And then, like I said in that video, that's just most important. You know, regardless of how you feel about it, and I'm not, you know, putting my two cents in or anything, I'm just laying out the facts. The same OEMs that are doing this were supportive of a similar voluntary program in MotoGP. Honda did it, KTM did it, Yamaha did it, Suzuki did it. They're fine with it. There is nobody, you know, in Japan that's just like, we're going to put the fight up. Like, they have millions of dollars on the line. They're going to do what they got to do to make this shit happen.
Yeah.
You know. I totally see where people are upset. I mean, I get it, you guys, you know, totally. But it's not this whole doomsday blackout theory of, like, we're going to protest at Anaheim 1 and shit yet. You know, God knows what could happen between now and January. But as it stands right now,
things change so often.
Yeah, but as it is right now, like, where we're going, there is no mandatory vaccine. Like, you cannot be barred entry if you don't. They'll just ask you to produce a test within 72 hours.
Mm-hmm.
And then, yeah, that's pretty much it, you know. So, yeah.
Yeah, you know what's funny is I had dinner this weekend with a really good friend of mine, been friends since childhood,
and we just got on the topic of the vaccine thing. And yeah, I mean, you know my stance. It's like, yeah, whatever. You know, yeah. It's I think I had it. I know you had it.
Yeah,
everyone
had
I know
it.
Closely that's had coronavirus has been like, you know, a couple guys I've known got messed up. Like mm-hmm. Michael Rich was in the hospital, got pneumonia. But like, I don't know. I just think it's overhyped. But that's my opinion, right?
Yeah.
I'm not going to tell someone that's super scared of it that they're wrong.
Yeah.
So.
Like my mom, she called me this morning. She's getting more and more scared of it, obviously, because her brother-in-law just dropped dead, you know, like today. Mm-hmm. And it's terrible. You know, there's obviously a lot of people out there who are taking it differently, you know, who are having their issues with it and stuff like that. So I feel like it's just such a touchy subject. I don't mm-hmm. know. Like, it's just weird.
Like it's funny because in one of our bike test videos, the Honda.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so you know how the Honda, the 21 Honda, final settings got messed up because coronavirus happened and
yes.
the last test sessions didn't happen?
Mm-hmm.
So I wrote, yeah, I said casually, yeah, you know, the coronavirus scamdemic screwed up the settings on the bike because it
yeah.
canceled the setting. Well, some guy heard that and DM me, yo, you called it the scamdemic, but like I've been listening to other stuff and you're vaccinated. So why would you call it? Well, okay, I'm vaccinated. I got vaccinated because my daughters have COVID fear 9000.
Yeah.
And that's what they wish me to do, right?
Yeah.
And my daughters mean the world to me and I would do anything that they want, right?
Yeah.
So it's like I'm not of the opinion like vaccine is evil, blah, blah, blah. Like
yeah.
that. I'm like, okay, I know people that got sick. I know people that got that didn't get sick. I know people that get the flu shot every year and get sick for a few days, you know?
Yeah.
Whatever. I got it. I didn't get sick. And you know what? It allowed me to go to Whistler last month and have
That's
the time
awesome.
Of my life,
yeah.
right? So I don't regret it.
Yeah.
But I don't feel one way or the other strongly
yeah.
about it. It's like, hey, if you want to get it, get it. If you don't want to get it, don't get it. But I think the government trying to force you to do it, that's bullshit.
Yeah, I think that's bullshit. I mean, obviously my mom, she's trying to push it on me a little bit. You know, just like, hey, I'm coming home. Like if I want to come home and see her, you know, she's scared. You know, if I get sick, I'll get her sick. My parents
well,
are getting
dude,
older.
If I was your parents and they know about your sketchy behavior
yeah,
and the wind and stuff, I would be scared of you anyway.
Get vaccinated for everything, please.
Yeah, exactly.
They don't have
right?
a vaccine for STDs yet. But.
Yeah,
they
you're probably
you back
right.
To, like, they take you back to your like pediatrician and get that like teenage HPV shot.
Yeah, yeah or something dad. Like just, yeah, just like
yeah.
have penicillin ready.
But yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's crazy how in Anton, some of the like factory guys were posting on their stories like, yeah, I'm out. Like if it's
yeah,
mandatory,
a lot
right?
of mechanics too. A lot of mechanics.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I mean, you know, to each their own. There's going to be a lot of guys that don't have it. There's going to be a couple guys that do have it. You know, and like. Don, to your, you know, to your thing, and I've said it, you know, into plenty of places. I don't have it, you know, and I'm kind of, you know, in this kind of limbo about like, well, do I get it or do I don't, or what, you know.
But funny thing, Anton, is about when people, like motocross people, find out I'm vaccinated, they're like disappointed in me, like, oh
yeah,
oh,
right,
dumb
and
shit,
then like.
Sold out.
Well, and then they automatically assume that I did it, and I'm just like, whoa, 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 whoa. Like, hold on, like, no, you know?
Yeah.
And so that's that thing where everybody is just so fucking combative of they're just like, yeah, yeah, bro, are you on our side, or like, you on good or evil? And it's just like,
okay,
you know,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
I'm, just like, I'm just hanging out by myself, not fucking bothering anybody, just let me do what I'm doing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm in the middle, you know? Like, I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, I'm the same way, like. Hey, I'm just whatever. If it makes life easier, hey, you know what?
Yeah. I mean, my daughters were like, Dad, you know, you're around so many people.
Yeah, and, that's where I'm at. That's with my mom.
And they're like, Dad, you're old. All right.
Yeah.
And they're like, Dad, you have asthma. You know, you're in the high risk. I'm like, no, I don't have asthma anymore. I mean, I have asthma, but I have it under control
because
yeah. of bicycling. But I'm like, all right, whatever. You know, I'd rather just get it and not listen to them flap their lips at me.
Exactly.
You know,
because yeah.
I'm not strongly opinionated one way or the other.
Yeah. So, Anton, if you get the vaccine at the races, do you still have to get tested?
Yeah, I'm sure we're all going to have to get tested regardless.
Do we have to pay for the test?
Because
still?
Yeah, that's what I was wondering.
I think they're trying to sort that stuff out, you know? But here's the other thing too. You're going to have to go pay somewhere regardless, right? You know, if you go to Walgreens and go do it, then you got to wait for them for the 24 to 48 hours for them to turn around your test, and then you're waiting and waiting and waiting. Mm-hmm. Whereas like the Feld one's super easy because they do it in 15 minutes. Yeah. You know, the only thing that I'll say about the Feld one is like practicality of it is a little funky because like there have been times that we've gone to the races, you know, and this isn't against Feld, this is just the common sense that we've completely lost touch with in the last like 18 months. But like, and it's the same thing at the airport. If personal space and all these things is so much of an importance right now, there's 30 people deep waiting to do it, you know, waiting to do their test, waiting to get on the plane, waiting to get the rental car. Like, you know, it's just, it's part of it, you know, so you just.
Yeah, airplanes are back to normal. Like, they're putting people in little seats and stuff, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, they're full. And, well, I mean, there for a bit, all the flights were, like, kind of empty. But they're starting to fill back up now.
Oh, yeah.
But,
yeah.
I mean, some of the flights were empty by design, right? Weren't they, like, trying to keep metal seats open?
Yeah, but they bailed on that.
Never
a
on American. Like, I fly American for the most part, and they haven't been like that at all.
No.
They've been middle seat.
Yeah. When nobody was traveling in those first, you know, 12 weeks or whatever, 6 weeks,
mm-hmm.
And the prices went really low, then they were kind of like, hey, man, spread out. Do whatever you got to do.
Yeah.
But now, like, it's on, dude. Yeah. I mean, think about us, just as Supercross. We did 29 races through the year. We went everywhere we needed to go, especially through the summer. We've really not skipped a beat anywhere. Every other corporation and every other industry in the world at this point is kind of operating at the same time. Some, a little bit different, but like business people are traveling again. You know, fashion designers, celebrities, all these people that have been locked down, they're going about it again. So it is somewhat back to normal. And then like, we're starting to see that now too, because, you know, flights are back to the normal prices that they were. Rental cars are still expensive, you know, but other stuff is kind of coming around. So it'll be interesting to see where we get to, you know, coming into Supercross 2022, because it's a whole new budget now. You know, teams are going to have to reallot for their budgeting. And so will everybody that travels to the races, because, you know, you're going back to the 17 races in 18 weeks all around the country, instead of 10 days in one location, in one rental car, in one hotel with one set of flights. Mm-hmm. It'll be different.
Yeah.
Yeah, because the schedule's totally normal now. Like, no.
Yeah, and there's a lot of travel. You know, there is a lot of travel. Some more back and forth across the country than I kind of had anticipated. But, mm-hmm. you know, like, they got to do what they got to do. And that's the most important thing right now, like, everybody's trying to go back to getting the money that they've lost out in these last few years. Go back to those markets where, you know, hey, there's going to be a huge fan turnout. Hey, we can kill it right here. We can make our money. We can do our ticket sales. The next week we can bring Monster Jam in, or maybe the week before Monster Jam was here. Like, Feld is going back to what they did for, you know, 13 years once they took over the series.
Mm-hmm.
The one thing I do have to say about that, I know a lot of people have been like, well, you know, let's just not go to stadiums that have mandates. Okay, I understand the thought behind that, but the big thing that you then have to realize is, like, in principle, that sounds okay, but then logistically, it's a mess. Because Feld owns or rents the dirt. Like, somehow they have to get the dirt to put into the track. Most of the time they own it, so then they have to source that for a new location. They have to find a location that's good for it. Typically, where they're going, they already have a contract in place because of, like, Disney on Ice or Marvel or Monster Jam or Supercross. So they're already in that area already. And then they have heavy equipment partners like a local Caterpillar dealership or a John Deere dealership or whatever, you know, that they can go get that stuff from. If you go to a whole new city with none of those resources there, you're done. You know, all that money that you would be making as an event, you got to buy dirt now. You got to find these relationships. You got to go through all that stuff.
And then it's not just a Supercross Saturday. It's like Monster Jam the following weekend. And stuff.
Yeah. I mean, there's so much stuff that goes into it that, like, you know, I know that people are just like, yeah, you know, everybody's trying to do whatever. But it's like, yeah, they're doing it because that's what works. Like, they know that's what makes them money. It's not some convoluted theory. Like, dude, people have missed out on a lot of opportunities for you know, financially over the last 2 years that they got to recoup from right now if we want to keep this thing going.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it'll be an interesting couple weeks, you know. I'll be interested to see how things are going between Thanksgiving to Christmas, because I think that'll be like that key time for everybody. That's when we'll all have to be watching, because, you know, people are going to get together with their families again this year. You know, after 2 years of not doing it, they're going to do it this time. You know, or maybe 1 year, however many it's been, but they're going to do what they're going to do. There's probably going to be, and let's just think about like common sense here. If you've watched anything over the last, you know, since 2020 to now, they're going to tell you, hey, there's a spike now because everybody was traveling or all these things were happening. And the thing about that for us is that all happens about 2 weeks before Anaheim 1. So if everybody gets sick and has all these problems, then you put your whole start of the season into limbo.
Wow. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Holy cow.
Okay. Let's stop the vaccine talk.
Nice.
This is where I'll take the commercial break. Let's hear from our sponsors.
Have you heard that Yoshimura is now making bicycle components? That's right. Their first product to market, the Chileo pedal, was over 2 years in development, and now they're ready for your mountain bike or BMX bike. Made in the USA and available in two sizes, you have to see these masterpieces of machining to appreciate them. They're most likely the last pedals you'll ever need for your bicycle. Now shipping worldwide, check them out at yoshimuracycling.com.
Hi, Swapmoto Live listeners, this is Alex Martin. At ARay, every helmet is handcrafted with dedication to pursue gains and protection, and that is exactly why I choose to race in an ARay helmet. This lifeblood of obsession with protection is driven by a single shareholder and runs through every person who builds an ARay helmet. This is what sets ARay apart. This is ARay.
Since 2005, Risk Racing has been a leading innovator within the motocross industry, all while doing it in their own unique way. Whether you are looking for the premier motocross transport system, the Lock and Load Pro, or the EZ Utility Jug, the fuel can of choice for me, SGB Racing's Alex Ray, Risk Racing is there to be your go-to motocross shopping destination. Head over to riskracing.com today and see their entire product line. Use code SWAP at checkout to receive 15% off the entire purchase.
Hey everyone, Don Moetta here. Over the past 20 years, I've built a ton of cool motocross project bikes. When it comes to choosing a great wheel set, my first call is always to the crew at WUSA. Importers and distributors of Talon, Kite, Hahn, and Edge hubs, the wheel building team at W is unrivaled when it comes to lacing them up to DID or Excel rims. Let's be honest now. Next, cleaning air filters or changing oil. Tightening spokes is one of the most tedious jobs when it comes to working on your bike. When it comes to wheel sets from W, though, you know that they'll stay straight and true, and the spokes will almost always stay tight. There's a reason that factory teams and top riders everywhere rely on W. When it comes to anything wheel-related, your one-stop shop is WUSA.com. Check them out.
Hey, this is Colt Nichols of the Monster Energy Star Racing Yamaha team, and I rely on Guiltless Food Co. to keep me fueled properly, feeling 100%, and is super convenient. It's healthy food that doesn't suck. Sign up at guiltlessfoodco.com.
Out here, on the edge, failure is no option. Here, you don't compromise. Off-road, on-road, on the track, off the grid. Sunstar sprockets and brake discs come installed in more motorcycles and all-terrain vehicles than any other in the world. Period. The engineers who design your bike trust and spec Sunstar for the same reason you should. Because here, on the edge, failure is no option. Sunstar, number one in sprockets and brake discs.
What's up? This is Christian Craig. As a motocross racer, being in top physical shape is a must, and my favorite way to train is cycling. And whether it's road biking or mountain biking, I rely on Roy Cyclery to keep my bikes in perfect running order.
Roy Cyclery has been servicing Old Town Upland, California since 1962. Mention the Swapmoto Live podcast for additional discounts in the shop.
Hey guys, it's Ryan Villapoto. Now that I'm living the retired life and not bound to factory team sponsors, I'm able to choose my partners when it comes to building my bikes. I choose Backyard Designs to create my motorcycle graphics because they do a great job. Their kits look great, go on easy, and last long.
Backyard Design has the most comprehensive and user-friendly graphic website in the sport. Use the discount code SWAPMOTO at checkout for a discount at backyarddesignsusa.com.
Welcome back to the Kickstart Podcast presented by our friends at ProTaper. The other big thing is, like, we just hit October 1st, right? So all the new, you know, all the riders and the team switches we've all known about have finally been announced.
Known about?
What?
Yeah, we didn't know nothing.
Yeah, I was shocked at Tomax on Star.
I can't believe that.
You know? Yeah. But beyond all the rider stuff, like, dude, the silly season, the real silly season right now is all the mechanics and the personnel.
Right? Yeah, yeah, everyone's moving around. Yeah, it's so weird.
So, like, we just had Seth Rerick in our studio, last week, to do the SML show. And we talked all about being the 250 team manager for Monster Energy Star Racing Yamaha.
Talked so about excited his journey, for the Supercross season. Yeah.
Talked about managing all 43 riders on the 250 team. And then, boom. He announces he quit. Talked to him this morning. He's going to Rocky Mountain ATV.
Yeah,
KTM
as a team trainer, which I've known that for a few weeks. Obviously, I was told to keep my mouth shut.
Yeah,
but you know what I mean.
So he's going there as a team trainer.
Yes, team trainer.
Okay.
And I think Seth. I mean, no, he definitely did a great job. You know, team managing Star, everything like everything this year. You know, I mean, hell, I mean the results showed. You know what I mean? He did a very, very good job. But I think Seth is just, like, at heart, I feel like he's a trainer.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I don't see him as a team manager, which he did very well with it, but I see him as a trainer, someone who's out there grinding with the guys and really overseeing it that way.
Totally. Mm-hmm. He enjoys it. I mean, even when he came here for the show, I mean, him and I were talking for probably 20 minutes before we started, and
he was freaking out about...
Oh, I haven't been working out this week.
Yeah, exactly. Like, he freaks out. Like, he has to be either running, cycling, something. Like, if he's not getting up and running 10, 12 miles in the morning, he's not happy.
Yeah.
You know, so, and I feel like the team manager role at Star, it took a lot out of him. Yeah. You know what I mean? And he wasn't able to do the things that he actually enjoyed. So, I feel like this move he's making over to Rocky Mountain is going to, he's going to be a happier Seth Rerick.
Yeah. That's good. Good for him.
It's just funny. Like, he came on the show and we talked all about manager duties and everything.
I think a lot of it was just spur of the moment.
Yeah.
Yeah. Spur of the moment. I don't think he had signed yet with the whole Star thing for the next year. Things were still in the works. And the opportunity came about and he was out of there.
Yeah. And I know that move took a lot out of him, even because, like, we were supposed to film a couple days. Like, we rescheduled Seth like 3 times.
Yeah,
and it was because there was movers at the shop.
Oh yeah,
and then they had to, like, dismantle the shop and take apart walls and stuff that they had. So there's a lot of logistical details that need to be worked out.
But that spot he leaves though at Star, like, that's going to be an interesting position to be filled, because Honda needs the same type of deal too. I'm really interested to see who goes where and just what they're gonna do. I mean, it's really not. We're only a couple months away from A1.
Yeah,
it's crazy to think about.
Yeah, Kehoe retiring.
Wow, that's.
It's funny. Crazy. Kehoe texts me back. Like, I text him, "Hey, congrats, whatever." He texts me back, but I'm like trying to get him for an interview or find more out, and he's ghost.
It's on vacation.
But yeah, so I mean. So there's that. And then, Anton, we were talking on the phone yesterday. There's a bunch of spots open at Star, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of the 250 guys have had some movements going on. I think people saw, like, J-Mart posted that, you know, Dwyer left. Dwyer was not going to be his mechanic at the end of this year anyway. Derek was, was going to take on a new position at Star. And then, you know, over the last few weeks, just decided not to for, you know, whatever reasons. And he's going to go to Gas and be with Pierce Brown. But then Jeremy thought that, you know, his longtime practice bike mechanic and his buddy from Minnesota was going to do it. And then now, and that was what they were going to do for a while. You know, that was even in the talks when they went to Millville in July. Mm-hmm. And then that's off the grid now. Jelly, you know, Justin Cooper's mechanic, he got promoted to Eli. Mm-hmm. So that's a big void. That's one of your title contenders in a big void.
Yeah.
I think that, like, there's a couple other guys that are on that team that are kind of, you know, sorting out what they're going to do, because it is a huge deal. You know, that move across country that, you know, we've all been talking about all summer has really taken a lot out of everyone, because not only are you working all of your race duties, you're also trying to get this property back up to what they want it to be. You know, Ricky and Jeannie and all those people, The barn was great and it did everything, but there, that was a practice facility. It wasn't a full race facility yet, you know, so they have a lot of stuff that they got to do. And similar things are happening at Rocky Mountain too. You know, Rankin left Christian being Christian's mechanic and went over to Rocky Mountain to be the crew chief now. You know, he has a big work on his plate for these next few weeks because, you know, they're going to do their engines in-house. They're going to have a suspension guy. They're going to have these other things. But he has three riders that they're all going to be responsible for. There's a lot of guys everywhere that have these things going on. PC went through it there for a little bit. Gas went through it because Rango left. You know, Rango left Malcolm after the Supercross thing was over, went and worked for Pierce through the summer. Gas wanted him to stay, but the whole time he had had that Cowie job to be Anderson's mechanic. So even guys that had positions in place, they were kind of just temporary positions because they knew where they were going somewhere else as soon as October hit.
Yeah. Even like just talking to a couple of star guys, I think another big thing, like especially for all those mechanics, I mean, it's not like they're going from Inland Empire West to Inland Empire East. They all kind of got there and were like, oh shit, this place isn't as developed as we thought. Like a lot of those guys, their houses aren't even ready. Like a lot of those kids are mechanics and riders are like living in trailers on the property.
Which is it's tough. And even like HEP, like Heart Wrap, his mechanic went to Pro Circuit. So it left him without a mechanic. Luckily, he found someone. But I mean, he took. I think he's taken Souls from Rocky Mountain, and Souls is going to work on a Suzuki. So, like, everyone is moving around. It's crazy. Like the riders, all of that, all of that shit sorted. And now it's like the mechanics. Like there's a lot of riders who are assigned that don't have mechanics right now. And it's crazy because everyone right now is starting to get, they've had their vacation, they've had their time off. It's time for them to get back to riding. And it's just like, oh shit, I don't have a mechanic. You know, so there's some mechanics right now, I'm sure, who are doing double duty.
Hey, Anton, is Brian Kranz retiring? Or where is he
going? No, Kranz is going to go in-house. He's going to be off the road, but he's just going to be a more in-house guy. I'm sure he'll pop up at the races and everything, but, I mean, he did it a decade plus. You know, he's – and that's so crazy, too. You know, I talked to Kranz a couple times at the last few races of the year just to be like, hey, man, congrats, great job on everything. Like, you know, you did it. And for how young Brian is, you're like, wow, dude, he was already one of the guys, you know. For how hard Eli rides the bike, there is maybe a handful of mechanicals in their entire history. You know, and it's all, it's not stuff that like was Brian's fault, really. You know, it's just riding the bike to the absolute limit. You know, there's just so many people that are out there that you already see these guys like getting to that level in their career. And you're just like, wow, dude, they're there. And it's so competitive as it is. Like, and there's some dudes that are already like, okay, do I leave it? Do I go on to something else? Do I keep doing this? You know, do I have kids? Like, it's a big deal right now for a lot of those guys. This, and ARay could attest to this too. Don, you can, and Chase, you can. Think of all the people you've talked to in the last 2 years. There's a lot of people that have had this kind of like clarity moment where they're like, is this what I want to do? You know, there's a lot of dudes that just don't want to do the travel anymore.
You know what the thing that, that's tough about that lifestyle is the year to year or 2 years to 2 years, like certainty of job security, right? Like, I mean, Like,
Kranz, it's a good time to be a mechanic right now. I feel like.
You know what I mean? It's the mechanics market, like the buyer's market, seller's market.
Exactly.
But like seriously, like as a professional race mechanic, right? You only know your job is secure as long as your contract is, and it's not like you're with the team indefinitely. Because big riders move and they bring their mechanics, or you know, stuff happens. So.
And it's not like they're making enough to put money away. Like I've talked to a couple. I think there's three pretty big name mechanics this year that are walking away and doing other things. And two of them I know are going into even more traveling schedule. They're going to be over, like truckers and be driving across the country instead. And just talking to a couple of them, like it's just
more job security and
more job security, more money. It's more worth it for them to be gone all the time.
Because these mechanics, I mean, they don't make money. I mean, I we're still on the hunt for a mechanic for our team as well, you know what I mean?
Is Cholo Mike still your mechanic next
year? I don't think he's going to be my mechanic next year.
No.
I think Jason has another plan for me. So so I think we're going to go a different direction. Which, I mean, it sucks, you know, me and Mike, we have that that relationship, but you know, it happens, you know.
You're not going to be your own mechanic, right?
No. Okay. Definitely not.
Alex Ray's mechanic could be the hardest working guy in the pits.
Exactly. And you know what's crazy, too? Like, we talked about Derek going to be a crew chief.
Yep.
I mean, I, like, when we were on Team Gus, he was Noah McConaughey's mechanic. And then he went from Noah McConaughey to me, and we did that whole year of Spider Energy. Mm-hmm. Best year of my life. Like, I still remember that full season that we did together. Like, I mean, he is one of my best friends. We call and we talk to each other all the time, you know, and to see him come from, like, someone like me and us having our issues and, you know, we're driving cross country in my motorhome, you know, to going to someone like Freddie and then Benny and then, like, Dakota Alex and then back to Benny and then Bogle. Mm-hmm. And, like, him just, like, climbing the ladder, right?
Yeah.
Just climbing the ladder. And then now seeing him as a crew chief.
Yeah.
Fuck, man. That's that, like, that makes it fucking,
yeah,
I like
that's
that.
Pretty rad.
Yeah.
That's cool. That's what I liked so much about Seth Rarick's story on our show, is he talked about the progression. And mm-hmm. then also Alex Campbell, Peanut.
Yeah.
Telling us how he climbed the ladder, right?
Yeah.
It's awesome to see that kind of stuff. Like,
yeah. Because I didn't pay, like, whenever we did that full season, I paid Derek $200 a week plus 10%. He had to drive the rig. He had to work on my bike. He had to put up with all my shit, like buy groceries and all of that, like all with that $200 plus 10. Ooh. Like, so, I mean, that was like, what, $300 a week?
Mm-hmm.
You know, if yeah. I made the night show and I didn't make the main, like, he wasn't making anything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And, you know.
Driven by passion.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Driven by passion. I mean, yeah. I mean, that was his dream. Like, he wanted to climb the stepping stone and work for a factory team.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, that was his dream. Like, he told me the other day, he's like, dude, because I just bought a CR250 for cheap. I don't know what I'm going to do with it. Yeah, I'm going to build it up and make
straight
a video
in
2023. Yeah, maybe. But, and he's like, dude, that 2002 CR250 Ricky's factory bike, that's what made me want to be a mechanic. That mm-hmm. bike right there.
Mm-hmm.
Like, just something like that just clicks in your head and you want to follow that career path.
Yep.
And, dude, he went to freaking no end.
Yeah.
To get to where he's at right now. He gritted his teeth and he just worked, which is awesome. And I like that story.
Yeah. So who is the top rider right now that doesn't have a mechanic?
Have we figured out who Mookie's mechanic's going to be? Because I haven't heard still.
I thought he was going to get CeeLo, but maybe that's changed.
Maybe, yeah, actually.
Dude, someone needs to call Goose.
Right?
Get Mike Gosser out of the woodwork.
Yeah.
You know what's crazy, too? It's like, we just had the Mini Major East. Ben Schiermeier is Chad Reed's family mechanic.
Yeah, like, that's so weird to see.
Yeah. Like, I mean, dude, the level of mechanic that Chad has working on his kids' bikes is just unreal, right?
Every time I saw him, like, walking with the little E5 or whatever to the line, yeah. I'm like, what the hell?
Yeah. I don't know. Still cool. So, I was cracking up when I saw McAdoo back on his bike, and he's number 48.
I know. Your bike looks good over there.
It's kind of funny how, like, 48 has ended up on a bunch of my homies, right? Like,
yeah.
Christian mm-hmm. Craig, Will Hahn, and now McAdoo.
Yeah.
Like, I'm just like, yeah, that's good. Club 48.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Hey, Anton, do you know anything about what type of threads AP is going to be in next year?
Oh, I've been hearing about
this. Haven't. I don't know. I honestly, I just started hearing that the other day.
I know a lot of people have a lot of bids in right now.
Yes, that's what I have heard as well.
Yeah. Honestly, I would be surprised to see Thor let them go. I know that there's, you know, a lot of people that are out there, but some of the people that I've heard, like, oh yeah, they're going to pick them up. I mean, I kind of hear about how they're doing right now as far as just getting product in, or like who they're going to pay, but just like, hey man, this is how much we're already committed to, and they're not going to take on another 450 level guy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like,
yeah.
some of the brands are tapped out. I mean, there's no question about that. And then you have to think, for like a brand like Thor, you know, they did all that marketing collateral and all that stuff, and AP is a pretty central part of that. So then do you just not get to use it next year?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You know,
well, he's already on the wrong color of the collateral that they would have.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, you know, it's funny. It's like, sorry guys. What is that? Stop. That's my eat alarm. But so like, we have Cooper and Thor.
Yeah.
Marvin and Thor. It looks like a team deal, right?
Yeah.
It's just them gobbling up the individual deals.
Mm-hmm.
And then like Dylan still being in Thor, he could have worn something else.
Yeah.
AP could have worn something else there. So it looks like Thor has all these team deals, but they're actually going after the individual guys.
Right. Yeah. I personally want, I would like to see him in something else. Just a,
I'd like to see him in some O'Neill RDX 2.2s, dude. Would you? That would be sick.
The thing with AP and KTM, though, and this kind of goes again for two deals that he has, Thor and 100%, they both have Power Pars items in the KTM catalog,
That's true.
Like official collab stuff. For them to have that, I mean, that's such a big deal for them. They put Marvin and Cooper in stuff last year that was co-branded stuff. And, I mean, I know that a lot of people don't think that, but they need that. You know, that is a big selling point for those brands. Mm-hmm. So we'll see. I mean, I'm sure over these next few days we'll find out. The thing that kind of throws me about AP leaving is he did just put a Thor, like, they just sent him some stuff and he put it on his Instagram the other day. So who knows?
Well, he's contracted through October 31st, I bet.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm. So.
Yeah, I've been hearing that's about like the only guy I've been hearing about that might change threads for next year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How about the Hymus's bike? That thing looks good.
That does, right?
Mm-hmm.
He changed numbers? Yeah, he
changed 21 to 2 now.
Yeah.
Two-digit
guy. Man, I mean, I don't know. That bike looks good, man, that Honda.
Mm-hmm.
Honda does look good.
You got red fever, bro.
No. No, man, I got the green fever.
Yeah. Well, okay, speaking of green fever, how about this morning Kawasaki introduced the
Works Edition.
The Super Race? What is the SR?
Special Racer.
Special
SR race. Was the Works designation for Kawasaki's forever. Like,
really?
When Jeff Ward raced the Works Kawasaki, it wasn't a KX250, it was an SR250.
Really?
That meant Special Racer, right?
That's awesome.
So
does it come with the actual A-Kit KYB suspension forks? Because they look good.
I know it's KYB as opposed to Showa on the production, on the standard bike, right? So, you know, our good buddy / landlord Jeremy McGrath downstairs this morning just told us it's fast as shit, right?
Yeah.
Compared to the Stalker. Mm-hmm. So it's got a, you know, poured and polished cylinder head, pro circuit pipe, Hinson clutch cover, not the Hinson clutch.
Yeah.
But the KYB suspension, I'd say the KYB suspension is the biggest wow of that bike, right? Because it's got different
extra rigs, I think.
It's got a different set of suspension than comes on the standard.
And you know as well, both factory riders are on Showa.
Right.
Which is weird. It's usually KYB and Showa, so they have that like that rivalry like there the,
yeah,
to like
exactly.
to go back and forth and better themselves, you know, but they don't have that. They just have the one Showa stuff. So
yeah, I think that was like a Eli like
that was an Eli deal. Like he liked the
KYB.
Yeah, part of it was Eli.
KYB guy.
Yeah, and then the extra clamp. I mean, I was disappointed. I would have liked to seen it come with a ride engineering clamp.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, X-Trig makes good shit.
Yeah, X-Trig. Yeah, they do.
You know what I like? I like the way they did the number plate on the side panels. The little small white thing.
Yeah.
I wish there was a 9 on there.
You think it would come with a number? That's lame.
I don't know. Doesn't everyone else do it?
Yeah. Maybe it comes with a 9 in the owner's manual.
Maybe.
You know,
That'd be cool.
Or like it comes, I think KTM's now, it's not on the bike, but it comes in your little pallet. You have the 2.
It was
2.
A 1 or a 2, right?
Yeah.
Or a
and so you can throw it on there if you want. Yeah.
I don't know. So, yeah, I think that bike's super cool.
Yeah,
it's already supposedly on dealership floors.
Today?
Yeah, and it's like 12,000 something.
12?
12.
Holy
shit.
Wow,
that thing's going to sell then. That's pretty. I thought it was going to be more than that.
Yeah. But I don't know.
I mean, considering, how much is a stock, just regular KX450 right now?
You're like 10.9, right? I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude, the pipe alone,
yeah.
And that's a full system. That's like $1,800.
That's a good deal.
Yeah,
and it comes with the green tip.
Does it?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
What?
That is sick.
Not the black tip.
That's
green
worth
tip.
It.
Yeah. Oh, Kenny Bell, he's not going to be a special anymore. He's got his little green tip on there.
What's up? I saw Kenny Bell got like a cool painted
helmet.
Dude, yeah,
he don't even ride.
Is insane.
So he's getting back riding. Okay, he's got to get ready for Day in the Dirt. We're getting ready for Day in the Dirt right now.
Only thing he's been riding lately is a golf cart.
Ooh, that's true.
No.
Golf cart and the buffet line.
No, Kenny Bell's been riding a couple local ladies.
Okay, well.
Oh, a couple local ladies.
You know, like, I mean, hey, he's getting his cardio in there a little bit, but he's been working a lot. He's still got to get his bike all fixed up. He was going to wait till after the season, you know, to get one of the the mechanics that lives down the road from us to work on it. He has all the parts, everything to fix his bike, all that. It's just he's been working a lot. He's been busy, you know. Dirt bike kids, man. It's been crushing it. So
it would be good to see him back at the track. You know,
luscious locks of hair just flowing behind his belt.
Right now, he's got nothing for Mike Condari.
Yeah, that's true.
Dude, not if you talk to Kenny. Kenny's like, dude, I don't have to ride to beat that guy.
No.
What?
Dude, that's Cooney's what been ripping.
Yeah.
Cooney has been absolutely ripping.
But, Mumford's first day on the bike today, right?
No, it's his second day.
Second day.
Yeah, he posted his vlog of him riding the last night. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, he did a video. He put it on his YouTube, an impersonation of Davey. He wrote all over himself, like, for, like, the tattoos and everything. He put a big circle on his calves. Like, oh, dude, my calves are so big. They're, like, hitting my frame. Like, all this stuff. It was to the T, actually. Like, everything that he says, I've heard Davey said, like, come out of his mouth.
That's pretty good.
He's like, oh, I'm training for an Ironman. I'm not worried about the bike or swim, just the run. And, like, everything in that video is just, like, spot on. It was so funny. You guys have to watch it. It's on Carson Mumford's on his YouTube channel.
Did he praise his wife a whole bunch like he's in trouble?
Yeah, I think so.
Did he?
Yeah, or something. He said something about his wife on there. Yeah. The whole family's here this week. I guess they're doing a race this weekend, so.
Yeah, if they're here to do a LA County race with us, they're like 2 weeks too early.
Yeah, that'd be a bummer.
Mm. They're doing some race, I think, in LA. Or LA County.
LACR?
Yeah.
I don't know what it would be.
Me neither.
Yeah. Huh.
Actually, is it State Fair?
No, we're not racing this weekend.
We don't have a race at all this weekend. Mm. Next weekend, we're in LACR, though.
Nice. Is it next weekend?
Yeah.
Is that quick? Shit.
Yeah.
That's why I'm going tomorrow. I got to figure out how to do those stupid 90-mile-an-hour jumps. Dude, you go to LA County after living in the Inland Empire, and the track is like fourth and fifth gear.
Yeah?
I mean, it just takes a little while to get used to, right? And then the jumps are big. They're not hard, but they're just, you hit them so fast. Yeah. You know? Like, I've done every jump at LA County countless times, but, like, when I haven't been there in a while, I go back and I'm like, puss.
Mm-hmm.
Scrub Daddy worked me last week.
Dude, Scrub Daddy's fast.
He is.
That
time on that Honda really improved his riding. That was a mistake.
Dude, Scrub Daddy's fast. Just accept the fact that Scrub Daddy's better than you on a dirt bike.
I killed him this weekend, dude.
You did?
Yeah.
Scrub Daddy's not a racer,
He waits though. For everyone to go, and then he just, like, messes around.
No, he started. He tried to start the first moto. I already had my helmet off and had a water bottle before he came back to the pits.
I always see him come into a corner, and then he'll, like, just do the rear brake, and then he'll look back at me, and then he'll keep going.
Yeah.
Scrub Daddy has the style, though. He's a style cat.
Yeah.
He's a style cat for sure.
You know what I noticed? I think he's on a diet.
Really?
Yeah,
really?
Did you notice his gut's smaller now?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, he looked a lot smaller this weekend.
Hmm.
I think he's training for something. I don't
know.
Day in the Dirt.
Yeah. No.
No.
I asked him if he'd be my team race partner for Day in the Dirt, and he said, heck no.
My dad's been getting ready for World Vet.
Is he coming out?
Yeah, he's coming back
out. Are we sponsoring Ronnie Ray?
I think he might ride one of my bikes. I don't know yet. We'll have to see. Or he might just bring his own bike.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, you let me know.
Okay.
I told Pablo I'd sponsor him too. I think Pablo's coming out.
Yeah. I think my dad, he's getting older. I want him to ride a 250F. I feel like he would have more fun.
Cool, we got one.
Yeah. Exactly. I feel like he would have more fun on a 250F.
Or a 350 if he'd ride a Euro bike.
No, he's a big Honda guy.
Big Honda.
Guy.
Right.
He's a big Honda guy.
Well, I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Yeah. So,
he might try something. You never know. He's my dad. So, like, that's where I got my hammer gas from. Like, it's either all or nothing.
Yeah.
If he's going down straight away, the thing's to the stop.
Mm-hmm.
And then just slams on the brakes whenever he gets a turn.
When you were back home, remember I gave him my, World Vet medal or whatever?
Oh, yeah. He's got it.
Does he have it hanging somewhere?
Oh, yeah. I think he's got it hanging at the pawn shop.
Yeah, he pawned it.
No, he didn't pawn it. No, I think he just got it hanging. That's where a lot of the trophies are. I sent you some of his Irwindale trophies and stuff that he had from like 79.
Yeah,
which is crazy. He still has all of his trophies.
Yeah,
and he has them all labeled underneath, like he would write and like the exact date and everything.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah.
So you rode dirt bike. Are you ready to ride a mountain bike?
I did Skyline.
No, are you ready to jump and stuff?
No.
No.
Okay. When are you going to be ready to jump and stuff?
No.
Never.
Well, that's the thing. I only have my e-bike that's full of suspension right now, my GT e-bike. I want to get a GT sensor. They don't have really any in stock yet.
Yeah.
So all I have is my hardtail. And I talked to Davey about it this morning. I was like, hey, do I need to get a full suspension bike? He's like, no, we're just going to go up and down Skyline. You know, we're going to be doing it numerous times, like up, down. Like, so we're going to be on
freaking that sounds really hardtails. Fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm on my GT's S-car. Well,
this weekend is closing weekend at Snow Summit.
Really?
Bike park, yeah. Jeez. What are you doing this weekend, Chase?
Why do I feel like we have
I got to watch the dogs. Why Kenny not? Bell has a wedding this weekend.
It's your last chance.
Wait, why do I feel like... No, that's next week.
I get too sketchy.
Yeah. I don't know. I went last weekend. It was a lot of fun.
Do you need one of these hoodies, Don?
When I ride a mountain bike? Yeah.
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 They're awesome. This money one?
So yeah. Whose idea was it to copy the Gatorade logo? Was it yours or was it the Temecula Tea guy?
No, it was actually like a chick that I was talking to. She sent me something and I really liked it. So I just sort of went with it, you know.
But can I critique one thing as a friend though?
Okay, what's up?
So I like what they did. The only thing though is the white is still there for the Gatorade ward. Like it's not
like right
trace.
Here?
Yeah.
Oh, I not see.
Not trace for the Y and the S.
Yeah, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, you know. I'll take your criticism, and we'll go from there. You know,
I just want to know what that hoodie is like after you wash it once.
Oh, it's amazing! It's great! It's fine. Don't worry about it.
For the viewers, does it run large or big, or large or small?
I think it runs a bit small. But yeah, I mean, this is a.
He's wearing an XL.
Yeah, this is an XL.
When he pulled that out this morning, I was like, "You're not an XL."
Yeah,
I'll put it on, and it's perfect, right?
Yeah, it does.
I'm a big boy. You got to think, dude. I've had a couple weeks off. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, got a little thick. The gear's a little tight. You know, give me some time here. But yeah. How's your merch?
Huh?
How's your merch?
Oh, last week's promotion was great.
Yeah, did you give away some good stuff?
Yeah, those three things.
Oh, I like that.
A Bubba helmet?
No. Christian's helmet.
Ooh.
A Bubba jersey.
Ooh.
And a Hanny jersey.
Oh, ooh, nice.
All good.
So I just dropped this stuff today. So anyone who buys a shirt and a hoodie, I'll throw in a sketchy hat as well.
Wow.
So, yeah.
You just be fitted.
Yeah, so just put it in the comments there on the website. If you buy a shirt and a hoodie, you'll get a free hat. And we also have like a new hat with this logo on it as well. So yeah, just go to alexray.co and get you some merch, dude. It really helped me out. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know what'd be sick with that logo?
What?
Socks. That would be hard. Just
that would be a good idea.
I hope you don't get a cease and desist if you get too big.
Yeah. I don't think I will.
You know, because when we were doing beer goggles, we did a beer goggle that looked like the Coors Light.
Yeah.
We got a cease and desist.
Yeah, well, I haven't got none yet. Yeah. I'm not that big. my quantities aren't very big at all right now. Yeah. So, we're good.
So,
any word on when AP's contract's being announced, Anton? I thought I heard it was today, but I don't think so now.
No, I haven't heard anything like that. Actually, I just saw that Star lost another mechanic now too.
Oh my god.
Who?
This kid Dalton. He was going to be an amateur mechanic. He was an amateur mechanic this year at Loretta's, and I think he was going to go pro, but I just saw that he posted his thank you to Star and that he's not there anymore.
Yeah, they don't have any amateur mechanics.
And they already lost Otter, right?
Yeah.
Otter's working for Chicken Little? Is he still working Chicken
Little? No, he's at Bar X now cuz Bar X needs two more.
Okay. You like that?
That's clean.
Yeah, that's good.
That's good. I like that. Yeah, I'm going to do that one. That's the next one. I was going to do like the Pornhub
NASCAR,
one, thing, but
NASCAR
I think someone took my idea.
Yeah, I just saw that this week, actually.
Yeah.
Who did it? Hemecula or something?
Yeah, Hemecula did it. Yeah.
You got it. Those are your neighbors. You got to go over there and just
just tell them to out.
You know where everyone's mind is.
Right? It's in the gutter.
Dude, speaking of being in the gutter, I don't know if it was for you, but dude, it was windy last night.
Oh man.
My trash cans flipped over.
Okay, so like the lightning was very, very bad.
Yeah.
It was very bad. I've never seen lightning like that in California.
Yeah.
And it was hailing insane on the way home from the airport for me last night.
Yep. Mm. It was insane.
You know how I know that lightning was a lot? Because it's all fucking anybody posted on this. Yeah, right?
Hey, so I want to say I do want to say a get well soon to Anton's buddy, Chris Kimball.
What did he do?
Crash his Harley?
Yeah, he did crash his Harley, broke his leg.
Oh,
it was a whole thing.
That sucks.
Doing a wheelie?
No, he was driving down the freeway. I think he was just trying to like split some lanes, I guess, through traffic, and a lady cut over on him. Yeah. Yeah.
I saw
that poor guy. Timble's been busted off twice on his Harley now, really.
Yeah. Yeah, but he's all good. He's getting his leg fixed up and everything, so you know, he got pretty lucky. So get well soon, Chris Kimble.
Kimble, if you want to get rid of those forks, let me know.
What forks that you want?
He's got inverted ones, which is like factory shit.
Oh, dude.
Yeah.
You're not over your Harley obsession yet?
Even more in love day by day.
Jeez, this guy. He's going to be hanging out at Cook's Corner like every day.
Cook's Corner.
Yeah, you know what's funny is like we're all on the same Google account because we're all logged in to the YouTube or whatever. Mm-hmm. So like I'll go to search something sometimes and I click the search bar and it pops down like all this Harley
FXDB
stuff. Yeah, is out. Looking for forks. I like, and then I saw it. Best assless leather chaps.
That's a lot.
Best leather vests. No, there is all this Harley stuff on my Google search.
Holy cow. That's awesome. But,
yeah. Did you find best way to let a abrasion heal? Did you see that? I Googled that.
No, did you really?
Because remember after Salt Lake, I crashed on Skyline in the dark.
Yes.
And I blew out my hip and I got that huge swollen thing and I got that big cut on my leg. Remember that cut didn't heal because I kept opening it with my knee braces and stuff. And then I got that cellulitis shit.
Yeah, it was
got
gnarly.
Infected like 4 weeks later.
Holy cow.
So this time, instead of going for the let it scab up in the air, mm-hmm. I've been keeping it bandaged with Neosporin all over it, which is what I had. But it looks pretty good, huh?
Yeah, not bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like it.
Did I tell you about that crash? I got a booby trap?
No. You got a booby trap? Someone like dug a hole and you just Indonesia'd?
I ran into a rope between two trees.
Oh, God. Ooh.
Like this lame ride called the Fullerton Loop.
Mm-hmm.
I went to do that because I hadn't ridden in so long. I wanted to just do a kind of ride that would keep my heart rate so. And there's only one real mountain biking section in it. And I was like hauling ass and saw this black rope in the shade at the last second. I went over the bars and landed on Fullerton Loop is like miniature golfing for mountain biking, right? It's fake. So dirt goes into a cement drainage culvert. And my leg landed on the edge, and I got this scrape, so it looks like a tiger got my leg. But
yeah, it does look pretty gnarly right here. It's like
do you put?
It looks better, though, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
When you get something like that done, are you putting peroxide on it?
When I got home, I put peroxide on it, and it foamed up and hurt like hell.
Yeah.
And I got in the shower, and it hurt like hell.
Yeah.
And then I just slathered Neosporin on it and covered it up.
So I learned this from, years of staph infections and shit.
Mm-hmm.
You're only supposed to use peroxide 1 to 2 hours after. Otherwise, it kills the bacteria trying to heal you as well. After that, you're supposed to use alcohol.
Alcohol?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No. Yeah, I did it within 1 to 2 hours.
Okay.
And then I put soap on a washcloth and just scrubbed.
Oh.
I mean, it hurt, but it don't hurt that bad. Or dirt bike.
Dude, back. You're sketchy on a mountain bike, dude.
Bitch.
You're sketchy on a dirt bike, too. I was watching at Paris, and you crashed. You were right in front of me.
When?
Whenever you were riding with Scrub Daddy. Your front end washed out or something.
Oh, you're watching the vlog?
No, I was watching it in person. I was there.
Oh, you were there.
I was there with Rob Bell.
Well, that was, I went into a part of the track that no one had ridden on yet, and it was all fluff, and I went over the bar.
Jeez.
Dude, if you don't crash once in a while, you're not trying hard enough.
I mean, I feel like, okay. I'm a try hard then. I'm like a freaking overachiever because I crash a lot.
Yeah.
But, hey, dude. You're a part of the sketchy. Scratchy family.
Yeah,
you know?
For sure.
Yeah,
for sure, for sure. And I'm an over-clutcher too, like you are.
Yeah.
You want to know why? How I know I'm a freaking retard with the clutch?
Huh?
Because I've been riding a Yamaha that doesn't have a hydraulic clutch now.
Oh no,
dude! I've been turning.
Oh,
you
just like.
Yeah. Actually, my buddy SMX. Pictures.
Mm-hmm.
He got a picture of me at the race this weekend, and I was all happy because I don't have my finger on either lever.
You're just like James Stewart in it, like just fisting.
Usually
it.
I'm like, you know, got the clutch half in and have my finger on the brake, but I was pumped. I had no hand, no fingers.
No, a photo doesn't exist of me like that. So
yeah,
it's good. Frame that one.
But anyhow, Anton, you have anything to contribute at the last minute?
No, I think I'm good. I'm ready to see you guys this week.
Oh, yeah. When are you coming out?
He's coming Saturday?
Saturday, yeah.
Saturday. Nice.
Wow. I have to think about that one.
Are we motoing?
Yeah, I'm ready.
What do you want to do Sunday? Do you want to moto or you want to go Snow Summit?
Let's moto because I want to ride that Honda. Or no, I don't want to ride that Honda.
What? Let me figure out what my
why would you ride a Honda?
Lady wants to do.
I don't know. I want to ride that 250F down there.
Which one? All right. The CRF 250R?
No, the KDX 200, the dual sport.
Yeah. back pedal. Yeah, so Anton's coming out for... Dude, the wedding is Thursday,
I can't believe
huh?
it. I'm, like, stressing, kind of.
I got to go to the mall and buy a suit tonight.
Yeah. I got to mic you up.
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, Casey says I absolutely cannot wear a GoPro when I marry them. Wouldn't that be sick? Wear a chesty under my suit?
I mean, yeah, but I mean, shit.
He doesn't want me
just
married.
Stash one, like, somewhere.
Yeah, he doesn't want he and his niece being married by me in my vlog.
Oh, man.
He doesn't want it in the vlog at all?
I told him that's a condition. I'm vlogging it. If I'm going to marry you guys, I'm vlogging it.
Oh, okay.
If I'm going to get ordained and go through that 4 minutes of pain on the internet,
yeah,
I get to vlog it.
I feel that.
You know, it took 4 minutes. Minister swap.
Jeez.
I'm just trying to decide what I'm going to say, if I'm going to say, like, all that, you know, like, two souls becoming one and
yeah,
all that stuff. I don't know. What did they say at the beginning? Like,
when yellow meets red, white.
Oh, God.
So what is yellow and white? Equal, like, off-white?
Yeah. That's kind of gangster. He might like that.
Huh? Off-white? Yeah. Yeah. And I'm going to introduce them as Mr. and Mrs. Casey Davis Maeda.
Oh, Jesus.
You know, because... You know, everyone in my family agrees that they should hyphenate, and it'd help him in motocross.
Oh, wow.
But anyway, once again, the podcast has taken a turn for the worse, so yeah, we're going to end it right here. But guys, thanks for listening. Sorry we are a day late. It's ARay's fault because he was on a plane.
Yeah, just let me make it up to you guys and just go buy some merch. Actually, y'all make it up to me, but somehow I'll...
He'll throw a hat in there.
I'll throw a hat in there, exactly. Go to alexray.co.
Alexray.co.
Hey, that Gatorade hat you have on Twitch, that's tight.
Right?
That was a big endorsement.
I know, right? I'm gonna have to
see. He didn't really have it on his head, though. He had it on top like a
yarmulke. Well, I'm gonna have to check my email. He might have to invoice me on that one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know?
All right. Well, guys, thank you for listening to the Kickstart Podcast presented by our friends at Pro Taper. On behalf of Alex Ray, Chase Curtis, and Mike Antonovich, I'm Don Maeda signing out. Talk to you next week. Since 1991, ProTaper has led the way in premium control components and prides themselves on providing an exciting, innovative, and complete product line to fulfill the needs of professional racers and weekend riders alike. Through revolutionary ideas like the oversized 1 1/8-inch handlebar and the micro handlebar kit, the only control system purpose-built for youth riders, ProTaper continues to push the limits and transform how we experience riding our motorcycles. Visit ProTaper.com for more.